It's been just over 3 months since the worst mass shooting in Canadian history. 22 people lost their lives after a lone gunman went on a rampage near Pate, Nova Scotia. Since then, there have been a lot of calls for an inquiry to be held, but neither the provincial or the federal government will commit to one at this stage. 37 Canadian senators have now added their voices, though, to those calls. They want Public Safety Minister Bill Blair and Nova Scotia Justice Minister Mark Fury to launch a public inquiry. We asked to speak with Bill Blair, but he was unavailable. The minister was unavailable. We've reached now two senators, though, who did sign the letter. Senator Kim Pate joins us from Ottawa, and Senator Paula Simons is with us from Edmonton. Hello, senators. Good to see you both. Thank you very much for making time.
Thank you, Ashley.
Senator Pate, I'll start with you. Why were you compelled to add your name to this letter? Why do you think an inquiry is necessary?
We think it's vitally important that all of the circumstances of this be looked into. There are so many questions, so much innuendo, so much concern about how this could have happened. There is ample evidence that, in fact, this man was known to the police. There had been reports of the fact that he was accumulating guns, that he was impersonating a police officer. There were certainly issues of misogynist violence, and we know too often when we've seen these kinds of mass killings, they've often been rooted first in violence against women, and that appears to be the case here. At least two of the victims were individuals with whom he had been involved, and there is also evidence that, in fact, he had stalked one of the women who has now come forward, who had been trying to raise concerns about his behavior in Pate Peak. So it screams for a very public, transparent process that examines all the issues surrounding violence against women, surrounding how someone could do this, why the police didn't notify as soon as possible that this was happening, why there wasn't at the very least an Amber Alert, why there wasn't a notice that this man was impersonating a police officer as soon as they knew that. All of those questions need to be answered, and in large part so that we can prevent these sorts of things from happening in the future.
For sure. Senator Simons, as Senator Pate was listing off those outstanding questions there, I saw you nodding. I should provide some background for our viewers that senators from Nova Scotia originally sent a letter, and now the two of you are among those who have added your names to this. Tell us why you wanted to add your name to this call for an inquiry.
Well, you know, in addition to all of the issues that Senator Pate had raised, there have also been innuendos in the media that the shooter in this instance may have been a confidential informant of the RCMP. There's not clear evidence of that, but certainly articles in Maclean's magazine have raised that possibility. And there are real concerns, as Kim mentioned, about the time it took the RCMP to alert people in the community that there was a gunman on a killing spree and an arson spree in their own neighborhoods. And so I think, you know, I thought back to my own time as a journalist and the number of cases that I covered in Alberta that involved RCMP and questions about RCMP conduct. I'm thinking particularly of the murder of the four RCMP officers at Rochford Bridge, carried out by James Roscoe. And there was a very useful public inquiry afterwards that looked at the way the RCMP responded to that. So I don't think it's unusual that there should be an inquiry after an incident such as this. And I have to say, it's my colleagues from Nova Scotia who come from a variety of different political allegiances in the chamber who have really pushed this forward. And I'm proud to sign a letter that Mary Coyle and Colin Dica and Wanda Bernard and all of the other senators from Nova Scotia, Stephen Green, have been pushing this issue. And I think because this involves the RCMP, it is a question of national concern. And I think that's why so many senators, and I have to say, senators who belong to the Independent Senators Group, who belong to the Conservative Party, who belong to the Progressive Group, who belong to the Canadian Senators Group. So it was a very, from all corners of the chamber, senators came together to sign this letter.
Yeah, I have to say, Senator Pate, I don't really know what the answer is around the question of why there hasn't been one launched. I remember conducting interviews with people who were, you know, traumatically affected by what had happened to their neighbors, to their friends, and right away they were asking for some sort of independent investigation. That manifested into calls for an inquiry very soon after what took place. There was supposedly one coming, and then I don't know where things have fallen off, but all I know is that the minister's offices tell us that they're working together, but there's no concrete sort of action being taken. I wonder what your thoughts are on that, Senator Pate.
Well, the longer it takes, the more questions people ask and the more it looks like something's being hidden. Oftentimes, an inquiry will wait until criminal proceedings have been completed. In this case, the man was shot himself. And so there are no criminal proceedings unless there is something happening behind the scenes that we don't know about, which we should also know about if there are people being investigated who may have somehow known about this man, if he was an informant, as has been alleged. All of that should be exposed as quickly as possible. It strikes me that it would be in the government, both governments' best interest to get all of the details out as quickly and as transparently as possible.
Senator Simons, go ahead. Yeah, you jump right in. Go for it.
In the absence of definitive knowledge, you get all kinds of rumor and innuendo and conspiracy theorists. And nature abhors a vacuum. When there's a vacuum of information, what you get is bad misinformation and disinformation, and that does no one any good.
Is there, there has been some conversation, or at least, conveyed to us that if the federal government doesn't participate or if the provincial government doesn't want to participate, that the other should pursue Senator Pate an inquiry regardless. Do you think to be effective it should be done in concert, or if it can't be, should one level of government pursue it?
Well, I think somebody should do it, and certainly there are all kinds of ways it could be done in addition to the ways that are being promoted, which is to have both ministers or both federal and provincial government appointed. There could also, it could be done through fatality inquiries as well that the Nova Scotia government could implement on its own. It could be done through an investigation that the RCMP initiates. There are a number of ways it could be done. The question is, why is it not being done yet?
And Senator Simons, last word to you. Has anyone responded to these letters? Have you heard anything back?
Not to me, but I'm not the main signatory to the letter, and so I don't know what the Nova Scotia senators have heard at this point. You know, I have to say, after 30 years as a journalist, I can be a bit jaded about public inquiries and whether we get much useful information out of them. The only point of having an inquiry, to my mind, isn't just to get the information, is to create policy to make difference so that you don't have an incident like this again. That's why I would like to see an inquiry, not for the sake of the political theater, but for the sake of getting public policy answers so that we can try to prevent incidents like this in the future.
Yeah, exactly, as Senator Pate said, to prevent this from happening again.
Yeah, I would absolutely agree with that. It's part of why so many of us have called for a feminist lens as well, because of the overlay of violence against women in this case.
Yeah, an important point. Thank you very much, both of you, for your time this evening and your insights. I really appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Senator Kim Pate and Senator Paula Simons. Hi, I'm Vashi Capello's host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video.